Rose Garden is the scene of an unprecedented newsreel record as President Johnson briefs reporters before delivering his State of the Union message to Congress. Then come the last-minute revisions before the President leaves the White House to address the joint session. His talk was written mainly by Ted C. Sorenson, his special counsel, but it took 24 writers 6 weeks to draft the entire talk. One of the shortest State of the Union messages ever delivered by a chief executive. Then, Press Secretary Pierre Salinger sounds the warning. It's time to leave for the Capitol. The day before he faced Congress, he discussed the speech with members of the Congress and representatives of labor and management. He also discussed the talk with Mrs. Johnson, who has often advised him on his speeches in the past. The First Lady and one of his two daughters escort the President to his car for the trip to Capitol Hill. Mr. Johnson had already indicated that he would cut the national budget. However, it was not until his first State of the Union message that the President revealed that spending for the coming year would be less than $98 billion. A drop from last year of $500 million. The President receives a warm welcome from his former colleagues and from the packed galleries. On domestic issues, he called anew for civil rights and a forthright attack on unemployment. His family looks on proudly.
And this administration today, here and now, declares unconditional war on poverty in America. And I urge this Congress and all Americans to join with me in that effort.
Announcing a 25% cutback in the production of material for nuclear weapons, the President had a warning.
We shall neither act as aggressors nor tolerate acts of aggression. We intend to bury no one. And we do not intend to be buried.